We are talking to one of the greatest ever, Michael. Michael, how are you feeling today?
I feel pretty good.
We're here. It's the weekend. Deontay Wilder, Tyson Fury. Give me your assessment on this fight.
Man, it's kind of tough. My man, what's the guy?
Deontay Wilder?
No, not him.
Tyson Fury.
Tyson. He hasn't been in the ring in a while. So it's going to be kind of tough for him, I think, maybe in a real fight.
That's true. No, I agree. And Wilder is 40-0 with 39 knockouts. In the history of boxing, who do you think are the top five biggest punchers, most powerful guys?
Sure, I couldn't say.
Top heaviest hitters you faced in sparring or fighting, guys that just hit?
Oh, man. See, I sparred with a lot of heavyweights. I sparred with Bone Crusher Smith. He hit me one day and knocked me clean across the ring.
You were hard to hit.
Well, yeah, but we had headgear on, and I was giving them guys trying to help them with their speed. So I got hit a few times.
Who else do you remember that hit very, very hard?
Man, I can't think of any of the heavyweights that hit me really hard like that. I can't think of it.
Adrian Broner, Manny Pacquiao, they're fighting January 19. What do you think of the fight?
Who is that?
Adrian Broner, Manny Pacquiao.
I don't know. Manny's been pretty good at defending himself, so I mean, I'll pick him.
Mikey Garcia, Errol Spence.
Errol who?
Spence. He's from Dallas. He's a 147 champion. Mikey's moving up from 35.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'll pick the first one you name.
Errol Spence. Okay. Now, what would fans who love you and miss you, what do you have to tell people who support you and they're watching this and they're thinking about you?
I just like to tell them hello and thanks for the support that they gave me when I was in the ring. And I appreciate it.
You and your brother did phenomenal things. What was your guys' secret of success? Was it God-given talent? Was it the work ethic? Was it something that drove you to that? What was it?
Yeah, I think it was the work ethic. You know, because I found out that if I got in shape, really good shape, I could win. And I got, my first tournament that I won was in 1974 and in Denver, Colorado. So the first tournament I went to was in 73, and I lost to the guy that won the tournament. I said, if I was in a little more shape, I could have won the tournament for the first time. So I said, if I come next year, I'm going to be in good shape. I said, and then I said, I'll see if I can win. And I did that. I got in shape for Denver, and I won. So that was my key.
In your opinion, besides yourself, who's the greatest fighter of all time? Can you pick one, or is it too hard to just say just X or just Y?
Yeah, I'll say Muhammad Ali.
Why?
Because he was charismatic and talked a lot of trash, and he backs it up a lot of times.
Did you ever get in the ring with him, either sparring or moving around? But you met him, I'm sure.
No, I let Leon get in the fight with Leon, so Leon did a good job in beating
him. What was it like being around Ali in general?
He's a character, man. I mean, he cracked jokes all the time, or he did little things.
The coins,
kind
of magic.
Crazy things. So he was a thrill to be around.
Today, in our era, drug testing and looking for steroids and supplements is very common. When you fought, there was no testing. And if there was, it was just for show. Do you think there were people using steroids in your era?
Yeah.
How do you know?
Well, I found out. I asked my promoter to see if this guy was on steroids. He came back to me and said yes.
Wow.
He had steroid injections, so I said, God damn, I got to go up against that too. So,
did you win that fight?
No.
But that's unfair if you lose to someone who's cheating. I mean...
Right, but like I said, they weren't testing then.
Was it common, though? Well, do you think a lot of people...
Not that I know of, because I had never heard that, you know, boxers using that, but I know that if they did, I mean, it made them pretty strong.
How did you know that your opponent was on steroids? What was it that made you think, like, his speed, his power, his body shape?
His body shape.
He was looking like Arnold Schwarzenegger, Rick Flair.
Yeah, I was looking
at him. Not a boxer shape.
I was looking at him. I said, hey, this guy been on something. So I asked my promoter, I said, see if he been on anything. So he checked it out, and it was
in your opinion, people who fail steroid tests, 6 month suspension, a year, or banned for life, what would you go with?
I couldn't say.
Are you guys flying?
Last thing, your favorite fighter in the world today, active, do you have any that you enjoy watching?
Man? No.
You don't? You just do that?
I very seldom see fights. But I do like watching them when they do come on.
You just flip channel. All right, there you are. And tomorrow you have a special panel here with 4 or 5 greats. Are you looking forward to it?
Yeah.
All right, there you have it. Stay tuned. Michael Spinks, FreeSnewsReport.com, Elie Seckbach reporting.